Welcome to Build Your Dream Network. I'm Kelly Hoey. I see people struggling to connect effectively all the time, so I created this podcast to help you master your network building needs. Whether you're seeking a new job, looking for a promotion, or scaling your business, you need a network, and you're in the right place to get the advice you need. And don't worry, my advice is real. It's actionable and practical because it's the advice I follow and is what has transformed my career from the traditional to the unexpected. So let's get started. You've signed up. Now what? It's time to revisit how to get the most out of attending conferences now that conferences have gone online for the foreseeable future. And rather than bemoaning the loss of networking serendipity from wandering around a conference venue, let's embrace the digital networking tools at hand. Those are conference apps, social networking platforms, hashtags, and the functionality on those live video platforms. A little confession first. When it comes to the first digital networking tool on my list, the conference app, I used to be the person with the incomplete profile who downloaded the app solely to access the conference agenda. Yes, my conference app behavior has changed dramatically, and so should yours. Download the conference app. Complete your profile. Check out all the features to connect with conference attendees, speakers, and sponsors. Those features you may have ignored in the conference app in the past, just as I did, whether to ask questions or post photos or answer polls or find communities of interest, well, those features are really valuable now. Those features are one of the ways you create the collision points you're missing by being unable to attend a conference in person. Check to see whether the app allows you to post questions to presenters before and after their live video streaming session. This little feature creates more engagement touch points and a longer tail to your event networking with the speaker as well as with the other attendees. For example, I recently keynoted at the Women in Tech Summit. The organizers have transformed a comprehensive two-day event into a two-week experience. The conference app, built on WOVA, is designed to encourage frequent engagement, including asking questions of speakers before a session, during the live session, and following the session. Conference apps are only as good as the intent we bring to them. So bring the intention to engage meaningfully, to not only seek information, but to respond and provide it as well. The second networking tool to get the most out of online conferences are social networking platforms. Yeah, the platforms you're already using. Here's how to leverage those platforms to get the most out of an online conference. Post in advance that you are attending the conference, as you may discover someone you already know is attending the event, or you could bring awareness of the event to someone in your network who should know about it. If there are particular sessions or speakers you're looking forward to hearing from, share that information on social media, as it may spark and unlock conversations from within your own network. Search or ask around if someone in your network has attended similar online events and ask what they enjoyed about it or how they benefited from attending or how they maximized the online experience. Yes, your attendance can be a powerful way to engage with mentors, managers, colleagues, otherwise known as your existing network. Let's move on to hashtags. Yes, you can amplify what you're learning or hearing by using the event hashtag. And you can use the hashtag to find the community coalescing around the topic being discussed at the conference. Hashtags first appeared on Twitter back in 2007 as a way to group or sort or find information and community. And today you'll find them pretty much on every platform with a social layer, including Peloton. Well, you can focus on using hashtags to increase the viewership of a tweet or a post or an update. You should also spend time searching hashtags to see who else is using them. Who is geeking out on the same topics as you? As hashtags will lead you to your tribe. And from there, use a like or a retweet or a reply or comment to initiate a dialogue with your newfound community. Last but not least, let's talk about networking on the actual conference platform, the Zoom, WebEx, Crowdcast, Hopin, Mixers, or whatever video platform the conference organizers are using. Exhibit behaviors that signal to the other online attendees that you're there to engage. Say the event is on Zoom. Come on camera. Use your name in your profile, not just your initials. Say hello in the chat. Answer questions others post in the chat. On that last point, during one of my recent online presentations, one very kind, very generous participant would find the links to the resources I mentioned in my talk, then post them in the chat for the benefit of the other attendees. No one asked her to do it. She just did, and I am so grateful. A Build Your Dream Network tip for asking a question at events that, well, it applies equally online and off. When you raise your hand or post a question in chat, say who you are, what you do, then ask your question. Why? You'll network further and farther with all attendees when the moderator or presenter reads out your question or unmutes you to ask your question. Another suggestion: while you're attending online events, leverage your out-of-office or vacation responder function on email as a networking tool by indicating in your message when and why you're unavailable. It may seem silly to use this feature during an online conference, but trust me, sometimes the smallest networking acts are the most powerful. Now, one last point plus three suggestions, and I'll wrap up this episode. My last point: recognize that actually attending an event is just the start when it comes to relationship building. It's one piece of the conference networking puzzle. What you choose to do with the opportunity before and after is as important as what you do in the moment. My three suggestions for networking after the event or conference ends are these. One, follow up with other attendees by reaching out on social media to continue the conversation. Two, email that question you wanted an answer to the presenter or panelist. And three, offer to lead a lunch and learn with your classmates or colleagues to pass on what you learned. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you back here again next week. Thank you for listening to Build Your Dream Network. Stay connected and don't miss a networking insight by subscribing to the podcast. And while you're there, I'd love you to rate and review the show too. Are you looking for more networking advice? Pick up a copy of my book, Build Your Dream Network. It's your guide to modern networking. I'd like to hear your networking questions, tips, and ideas. Connect with me via my website, jkellyhoey.co. You'll find links to all my social media accounts, plus a contact form to email me your questions. I'm Kelly Hoey, and I'll be back again next week to tackle your networking challenges.